This is At Home with ADTS, a monthly program that presents topics that may be of interest to older adults and their caregivers, as well as talking about the services offered by Aging, Disability, and Transit Services of Rockingham County.
Hello, and welcome to the January edition of At Home with ADTS, a monthly show brought to you by Aging, Disability, and Transit Services of Rockingham County. I'm Cathy Powers, the Executive Director here at ADTS, and my co-host is Asheley Cooper, and we are joined today by our guest and Senior Director of Transportation Services at ADTS, Meggan Odell. We like to start every show off by thanking the businesses that have supported us over the past year through our Community Partners Program. As the aging population continues to expand, these local businesses and their support is helping us to meet the ever-expanding needs here locally. So thank you as always to Carolina Apothecary, Pelham Transportation, Home Trust Bank, Wells Fargo, CJ Medical, Sparks Oil, the Rockingham County Community Foundation, Rockingham County Arts Council, Colonial Funeral Home, Church of the Epiphany, JDK Automotive, Wilkerson Funeral Home, Annie Penn Hospital, Eden Rotary, Reedsville Rotary, Plaza Mini Storage, Woodmont United Methodist Church, and Mohawk Foundation. We also like to give a special thank you to the United Way of Rockingham County for their longtime and generous support for the Meals on Wheels program. United Way of Rockingham County brings together local people to raise local dollars to meet local needs. We thank everyone who's already participated in this year's campaign, and we encourage you to get involved. Now we're going to turn the focus over to today's guest. Thank you for joining us, Meggan Odell. First, just introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about your background and your role here at ADTS.
Okay. Well, I'm Meggan Odell. I'm Senior Director of Transit Services. I have been in that role for about 14 years. It'll be 15 this year. Boy, time flies when you're having fun. I actually have a background in civil engineering, so this is kind of not anywhere near what my background is, but I enjoy what I do every day.
Wonderful. So transportation was what we're going to talk about today. RCATS, SCATS, the vans everyone sees around town. There's two divisions, right? Mm-hmm. So there's RCATS and SCATS. Let's start with RCATS. So what exactly is RCATS?
Okay, so RCATS is what we like to call our demand response or subscription service. And what that means technically is that we come to your house to pick you up. We're curb-to-curb service, but we come to pull in your driveway, pick you up, and bring you back after your appointment or after wherever you're going. So that's our demand response subscription, and those are the vans that you see everywhere. They're all over the place.
How many vans do you have?
We have 22 vans, uh-huh. Which 19 of them are on the road every day.
Okay. Oh, wow. And some of them are wheelchair accessible?
Yes. 18 of the 19 that are on the road every day are wheelchair accessible.
Awesome.
And does that stay just in the county, or does it go out of the county?
It stays just in the county. We just provide service just to Rockingham County citizens. We actually have we do provide some Medicaid service for out-of-county appointments. That's through our network of partners that we have with CJ Medical, Safe Hands, and Pelham Transportation. But our vans actually don't travel outside of the county.
And you just mentioned Medicaid, so I think it's a good time for us to remind the listeners that we are the one call center for Medicaid transportation as Medicaid currently stands.
Yes.
So even if they were seeking a Medicaid appointment out of county, even though we might not actually go out of county, they would still call our office.
Yes. We do all of the backroom paperwork stuff, check all of the eligibility, check on the doctor's appointment. So you would just call our office, one number. We take care of everything for you and get you set up with a ride.
Seems like an efficient system.
Yes, definitely.
So you mentioned individuals who have Medicaid can ride. Who else is eligible to ride?
For the RCAT system, anybody is eligible to be able to ride. Now, Medicaid pays for doctor's appointments and other medical kind of things that you would have if Medicaid's paying for the visit. But we actually do transportation for the nutrition sites across the county. We do transportation for RCC, for employment, and then anybody who doesn't have Medicaid or who kind of falls in that gap, we provide service for their medical appointments as well.
So how are, do they have to pay for it? Do they pay on that day? Do they get a bill? How does that work?
There's a small fare charge for people who are riding who don't have the Medicaid or don't have any other funding source that pays for it. There's some groups like Vocational Rehab and Department of Health and Human Services that pay for some transportation. So it's important to talk to your caseworker to make sure that you don't qualify for something that will pay for your transportation. But if you don't have anything that'll pay for it, then we have the fare charge program, which is $2 or $3 each way. And that depends upon where we pick you up from and where we're taking you to.
So if someone were to call and schedule an appointment, would you be able to tell them then immediately if they fell under any of the coverage or if it was going to be a fare for them?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. So they would know in advance.
Right, and we can lead them in the right direction if they would qualify for something else.
Now, do they have to have exact change when they go?
They do have to have exact change. Unfortunately, we're not in, you know, the modern futuristic mode yet. So we don't take debit cards or anything like that.
No Venmo.
Okay. No Venmo, no cash apps. But we do just take money orders or cash.
She said yeah.
Yeah.
I heard an opportunity for advancement there. Over 2020 we'll move into the next phase.
Definitely some technology advancements.
So how does someone go about setting up transportation if they're new to the area or just never tried it before?
Okay, so with RCATS we require 3 working day notice, and that's just so that we have enough time to give it to the drivers and they know where they're going and we're not giving it to them on the fly. So 3 working days, somebody calls their telephone number, gives us their contact information, and we get emergency contact stuff, all of that good stuff, and when their appointment is, and then we'll give them the eligibility requirements if they need to meet some to as far as fare charge or if they're going to have another funding source pay for their transportation, and then we're able to give them a pickup time at that point. And so then the driver arrives to pick them up. Whenever they're finished with wherever they're going, they just call and let us know when they're done. We send the driver back for them.
So I'm sure that some of the folks, as we mentioned, wheelchair accessibility or on walkers and those sort of things, do drivers help them on and off the van, out of the house? How does that work?
We don't help out of the house. We're not allowed to help anybody out of their house, so to speak, but we do help down a ramp or in into the van and those kind of things. Also into the first threshold of the doctor's office we're able to help in too. So but we're kind of tied to regulations with NCDOT as far as helping. We do allow everybody to have one attendant to ride with them though.
Okay.
So if they do require some extra attention or extra help, they can have that person.
That's great.
With them.
Would they let you know in advance, I assume?
Yes,
okay.
They could. And we have had instances where we've pulled up and there's been somebody extra. And as long as it's not, the van's not packed, we're good.
Understand. So how many trips per year are y'all providing?
So on the RCAT side of things, we provide somewhere in the neighborhood of 60,000 trips.
Wow.
And that's not including the out-of-county trips that we do, just the administrative paperwork for and the dispatching kind of. And so we're driving about 725,000 miles a year just within the boundaries of Rockingham County.
Wow. That's incredible. That's absolutely incredible. Do you find that the same type of people utilize the service, or are you seeing that there's a variety?
There's a variety of people. We have some that children that are going to daycare and parents are going to work. We have some that are 98 years old going to their regular doctor's appointments, and then all kinds of people in between. So it's really not just an elderly population and not just a Medicaid population. It's everybody.
One of the things that I've been excited to see is how many partnerships that you've built with different public service organizations and businesses and the college. Maybe you could talk a little bit about the partnership that we have with Rockingham Community College and how people have been able to utilize the system to access education.
Yes, absolutely. We are fortunate enough to have a community college that's very engaged with getting their people to school and how to make that happen for people who don't necessarily have the means. So they have been integral in coming up with ideas of how we can make that happen. So on the SCAT bus side of things, we provide transportation through connector system, and the people are able to actually bypasses through the community college through their Pell Grant or any kind of financial aid that they're receiving, or they can just take cash into the bookstore and buy a semester pass and then ride the SCAT buses and the RCATS vans as the connector system to be able to access school, which is incredible. We have a lot of people who are doing that.
Yeah, the community college is doing some great things, not only to bring people to the campus, but also to get into the high schools across the community. It's really exciting to see everything going on. So you've mentioned SCAT, so it's a great time to segue into that. What is SCAT, just 30,000 foot perspective, and how is it different than RCATS?
Okay, so the SCAT bus is what we call a deviated fixed route system. And so what that means is that it has fixed stops that we stop at every hour on the hour, or try to every hour on the hour. And we can deviate from that by 3/4 of a mile. So if there was somebody who had a need that lived along the route that was within the 3/4 of a mile, we could kind of venture off to pick them up if they couldn't get to a stop otherwise. But the difference is you don't have to call in advance. You don't have to let anybody know you're going anywhere. There's no eligibility checks. There's no checking to make sure you actually have a doctor's appointment or anything like that. You can just show up at a stop and be ready to ride.
Oh, that's fantastic. So, and is there a cost associated with that?
There is. It's $1 for every time you get on a vehicle. And the reason we say every time you get on a vehicle is because we do have that connector system. So sometimes people will try to travel from Eden to Reedsville and there's a connector between that. So they would have to pay the $1 to get on the connector to ride to. So so it's $1 every time you transfer onto a threshold of a vehicle. But $1 is great compared to $2.75 gallon gas or whatever. So,
and over a certain age and under a certain age, there's no charge?
Yes. Under the age of 3, there's no charge, and over the age of 72, there's no charge.
Can people ride, teenagers ride, or what's the requirement around
that? If they are 16 years or older, they can ride, which is a little bit different than RCATS, because RCATS, we require that they be 18 or older. 16 years for the SCAT bus, and that's because we do some transportation for the high schools. Both Reedsville and Moorhead High School are along the routes in their particular areas. So particularly on exam days when school gets out early and the buses don't travel until regular time, we have a lot of kids who
coming up next week.
Yes, they get on those on the SCAT bus and can get home a lot earlier than they would if they had to wait at school. So we have that good partnership with those two schools.
Now, you mentioned the word connector a couple of times. Can you explain what that means and where those sites are?
Okay, so the Walmarts in Rockingham County, the 3 in each of the locations of the county, serve as our kind of depots. Since we don't have fixed depots anywhere, they serve as our they kind of serve as our connection points. And so what happens is all of the SCAT bus routes travel to Walmart, because obviously that's a cool place to go, and everybody needs to go to Walmart at some point. And that's where they can meet an RCATS van, which acts as the connector on the SCAT system that can take them between the Walmart. So like from Eden to Reedsville, they could meet the Eden driver. He would bring them to the Reedsville Walmart, and they could either access Reedsville Walmart at that point or get on the Reedsville SCAT bus. There's also a connector that would meet them at the Reedsville Walmart. They could take them out to Wentworth, and they can access all the services out there. So there's 3 connectors in total running with the 3 SCAT buses.
Okay. So how long, just out of curiosity, if I started off in Madison and wanted to get to Reedsville, how long would that take me to do that?
It would take you about 1.5 hours to do it.
Okay.
Because, and it would depend upon where you were on the route compared to how you could get to Walmart. So if you were at Mount Villa Apartments, let's just say, and you got on, you would get to the Walmart about 10 after the next hour, and then you would get to Wentworth by about half after the hour. So if you started out at 8, you would get there about 9:30. So it's not bad, bad at all. And you're changing, it's different scenery, so it's not like you're riding
on
one
30
vehicle.
Minutes drive across anyway, 30-45 minutes.
So. You have a beautiful county.
We
just
do.
Sit back and enjoy the
Yes, and the drivers are great. So
you do have fantastic drivers. I have to say, we utilize the RCATS for the Leaf Center, and that's always whenever we do our surveys, they all come back and say the van drivers are fantastic, and I hear that across the board. So
they become family for sure.
They do.
People that they transport.
So. They absolutely do. So now when we talk about partnerships, though, I know that there is a way that you can utilize SCAT in Eden, I believe, where it can go the opposite direction.
Yes.
Can you talk a little bit about
absolutely.
That, which I have butchered it, but.
Yes. No, you've done fine. You've done fine. So Mike Doherty in the city of Eden, who is in the economic department there, is a huge advocate for workplace transportation and really pairing the industries up with the available resources in the county so that they can have good educated people doing the jobs that they have, that we have in Rockingham County. Mm-hmm. So he came to a transportation advisory board meeting one time and was like, how can we make this work? How can we make SCAT work? And the problem was, is that SCAT runs normally from 7 in the morning to 8 in the evening, Monday through Saturday. Well, most industries, their first shift starts at 7. Mm-hmm. So we were kind of missing those people and not being able to get them to work because we were an hour later starting. So what we came up with was a reverse route in Eden and running it the exact opposite of the way it runs normally. So we're picking up people starting in the Leakesville Spray area and then ending in the Draper area where the industrial park is, KDH, Gildan, and all of those places. Mm-hmm. And picking up people and taking them to work starting in the 6 o'clock hour so that they're able to get there. And we're only doing that in the Eden area currently. That's another yet.
Okay, we're writing all this down, Meggan. Goals for 2020.
Yes, exactly. We want to be able to bring that to the Reedsville Industrial Park as well and to be able to service the Western Rockingham County Park with that too, because we recognize they have industries that operate the same way. So we're trying to figure out how we make that make sense. It's not just as easy as turning the route backwards as it was in Eden. Eden's was kind of a cinch because we were able to do it. But Reedsville Industrial Park sits a little bit off of the beaten path. Mm-hmm. And the Western Rockingham industries are kind of separated. So we're trying to figure that out. So that's definitely coming. But we've seen upwards of 70 people utilizing that SCAT to work service. Yeah. It's kind of a revolving door though, which is awesome because we have people for 2 or 3 weeks that ride it. And then by then they're either able to have saved enough money that they could purchase a car or they found a friend that works on the same schedule. Mm-hmm. So they're able to just kind of move out and move into something different. So mm-hmm. it's kind of neat to see all the people to rotate through.
That's awesome. Yeah,
truly meeting a need.
Yes.
Truly meeting a need.
Absolutely. So shout out to Mike Doherty for helping that. Yes.
I gotcha. So let me ask you this. How far out in the county does SCAT go?
So SCAT runs within the city limits of each of the okay. cities. So in the city of Reedsville, the furthest point is on Freeway Drive, Walmart area, and then comes back into like where Reedsville Nissan is, and then covers like downtown Reedsville and goes back into the Wentworth Street area. City of Eden covers Leakesville, Spray and Draper's downtown areas. And then Western Rockingham covers Stoneville, Madison, and Mayanand's kind of downtown areas as well. That's been the most tricky, I think, because we're putting three together. Mm-hmm. So they have the least amount of stops. They have 14 stops and compared to the other two that have about 22 stops on them. But that's just because there's more travel time in that hour mm-hmm. to be able to get from those cities. But Western Rockingham has seen a jump in its service in the last couple of months. Reedsville and Eden have always run neck and neck. I think it's a it's a kind of a game to see who can have the most trips. But Western Rockingham has really spiked up. So I think the word is out there for sure that we have the service and anybody can ride it.
And what were the hours again?
It's from 7 in the morning to 8 in the evening, Monday through Saturday.
Okay. And the connectors only run Monday through Friday?
Monday through Friday, yes. And they run from 7 in the morning to 5 in the evening.
So if someone wanted to figure out which stop is closest to them, how would they go about figuring that out?
Okay, there's several different ways. We have route guides that we can provide. We try to put them in all the Chamber of Commerce's and doctor's offices and DSS and Health and Human Service places.
And that's an actual map.
That's an actual map, uh-huh. Okay. And so it'll have it at least each time that it's actually at a stop. And then they could call. You know, if you get it, we have a lot of people that call and like, I'm new to the area and I'm not really sure where I am in comparison to this mm-hmm. stop. Can you help me get there? So we definitely can help provide that service within the office. All of the staff are trained on the SCAT routes and know how to tell people to get there. And then we have something kind of new that's exciting is in conjunction with Google Maps is that you can actually punch in where you are and where you want to go to and hit the little transit icon. Yay. And it'll pop up and tell you what your distance is to walk to the nearest stop and then what bus you'd get on and then how you would transfer and all that good stuff.
So, oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. So we are moving into the technology.
And eventually, correct me if I'm wrong, Meggan, but eventually that's going to have a functionality where it will tell you like where the bus is.
Yes.
It'll actually locate the bus. And so if the bus is for some reason running mm-hmm. a minute or two behind, you'll know that. And you'll know you didn't miss
yes.
it.
Yes. That's awesome. Absolutely. And that is going to help so much because with construction and sometimes if we have a wheelchair and we have to load it and things mm-hmm. like that, mm-hmm. we don't necessarily know that in the office that the bus has had to take a detour or they're a few minutes late. So we just have to say, oh, it's on the way. This is the mm-hmm. time that it's supposed to be there. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be awesome to be, because we in the office can then log in and say, oh, we see where it is and it's going to be there in 2 minutes or whatever. So yeah. we're excited to actually have that feature.
Well, and the 1 hour loop thing, I think it's just kind of important to put it out there because a lot of times people will say, hey, can we add this place or why don't you add that place? Keeping it on the 1 hour loop is really important.
Yes.
And so a lot of times if you add anything to keep it on that 1 hour loop, you have to make a decision to eliminate another stop.
Right.
So that's kind of a evolving process. Mm-hmm. I know that the routes have changed somewhat over the last few years, but mm-hmm. that's kind of a, there's a process involved in that because any addition is also going to mean the elimination of something else. And so
right.
that's, comes
right.
with consequences.
Yes.
Every decision comes with consequences.
Yes, so. Definitely. We've always said from the very beginning when we launched Eden's bus in January 2013, which seems like forever ago and sometimes yeah. seems like not that long, that the people who rode the bus were actually going to dictate where the bus went to. I mean, because we want it to be for everybody.
They're driving the bus.
They're driving the bus, exactly. And so we've changed it a lot. I mean, we add Freedom Park in Eden in the summertime because there's all kinds of cool things yeah. going on there. But then in the wintertime, there's not so much, so we take it away.
Yeah.
So there are some things that we have a little bit of fluidity to be able to do. Mm-hmm. But for the most part, it is correct that if we're going to add like a new apartment complex or we're going to add another new place, we have to analyze what the other stops yeah. look like and if we're picking up people because we don't want to impact people who are using it on a daily basis.
Right.
And people are using it for their for everything.
Yeah.
So what does ridership look like on SCAT?
Okay, so SCAT bus ridership is somewhere between 33 and 35,000. And that's all three routes totaled.
Trips.
A trip.
People getting on and taking a trip.
Right, yeah. Exactly. Okay. And they travel about 200,000 miles, but that's just because they're just on that kind of mm-hmm. loop. And so it's the same 13 miles every hour that they travel. Brakes are expensive on the SCAT bus.
A lot of tires,
a lot of brakes.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, and it just continues to grow. I mean, the connector systems continue to grow every month. In the wintertime, obviously, is when we see kind of a slowdown because people don't want to stand at a bus stop and wait necessarily. But December's numbers were great. So we're hopeful that that's an indication that they'll be good for the rest of the wintertime too. So
let's keep 70 degree temperatures.
Yes,
out in the winter.
Yes. And no rain. Yes.
Well, I was going to say, actually, you mentioned no rain, but I know quite a few stops have benches and little lean-tos. And,
yes. And that's been just kind of a community effort.
Mm.
The city of Eden purchased some bus stops, shelters and benches for some of their most frequented stops. The town of Madison had some people build them. Lowe's Home Improvement in Mayadan has done some excellent stuff of trying to add things, some bus stops and benches. So it's incredible that it's brought so many people to the table. So.
Great service project if somebody wants to
yes.
get involved and,
yes.
and do something.
Yes, absolutely. Just shows you how wonderful Rockingham County is.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
What a great team we are.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
Anything else, Meggan, that you want to share that's just kind of a burning
No, I think
topic.
That's it. I have lots of goals for 2020, obviously.
Yeah, clearly. We wrote them all down.
No pressure.
No pressure, yes.
So if someone wants to get in touch with us and schedule transportation or they have a question, what number do they need to call?
So the main transportation telephone line is 336-347-2287, and that's 34-RCATS. So if you forget what that 2287 is, it's 34-RCATS.
Okay. And then we also have information available online.
Yes.
We have a SCAT page mm-hmm. specifically that has all the routes and information about you know, questions that people might have and who's eligible and what the code of conduct is and all that information. That's rideskat.org.
Yes. Right. And that's S-K-A-T instead of S-C-A-T.
And you can also access that through our main website, which is ADTSRC.org.
Yes.
ADTSRC.org. Yeah. would also take you to the SCAT page as well. Well, I think that's it for us today. Okay. Well, lots of exciting things going on, Meggan. Lots of good things in the pipeline, it sounds like.
Absolutely.
So, again, that's all we have time for today. We hope you enjoyed listening to Meggan and learning all about transportation here in Rockingham County. If you have any specific questions regarding transportation, you can contact the Transportation Department, again, at 336-347-2287 or visit us online at adtsrc.org. We also hope you can join us again next month when our guest is going to be here to discuss the upcoming census and some changes and how that data is collected and the importance of getting an accurate count and make sure that we all know what's going on in advance of the census count. So we again thank you for joining us and we'll see you again next month.